So I'm Michael Cumpsty, and I'm directing this production of Wendy Wasserstein's play Third. Third is about the relationship between the two central characters. There's a woman called Laurie Jameson, who's a professor of English, a very accomplished, successful woman. And there's a young man called Woodson Ball III, who is a student at the school where Laurie Jameson teaches. And he is a wrestler, and he comes from a conservative background, and Laurie Jameson is sort of fiercely liberal, and she's a fiercely feminist. The relationship between Laurie and Third becomes very, very tense, because essentially Laurie is sort of prejudiced against him for political reasons. And what the play is saying, what Wendy Wasserstein is saying, is that if you have those political prejudices, if you make an assumption about somebody, then you're going to miss the best parts of that person, which in the case of this story are the fact that he is a brilliant young man. I was certainly a fan of Wendy Wasserstein's before I got involved in this project. I think she's a fantastic writer. If you look at her plays, her earliest play, Uncommon Women and Others, and then this play, Isn't It Romantic, they are funny and insightful and witty and everything, but you can feel her maturing as a writer through them. And then you get to the Heidi Chronicles. She wrote other things in between, but the big plays, she got to the Heidi Chronicles, which was extraordinarily successful. It won her the Tony Award for Best Playwright, but it also won the Pulitzer Award. She moved on and she wrote a play called The Sisters Rosenzweig, which was another big success on Broadway. And then she wrote this last play. And what is singular, I think, about this last play is that she wrote it when she was very, very sick. She died just months after this play was originally produced, and she had been sick. They had a very hard time figuring out what was wrong with her, and so she'd been sick for years. I'm not saying for a minute that I know that she knew she was going to die or anything like that. I don't think she did, but she did, understand what fear of mortality felt like, you know? This woman wrote a play in which the person who is blinkered, in which the person who is blinded by prejudice, is on her side of the political divide. She's writing about a woman, in some ways quite like herself, who cannot see the brilliance and the goodness, the deep, deep, deep goodness in this young man, simply because she assumes he's conservative. And Wendy seems to me to be saying, prejudices can cost you. They can really cost you. When you're preparing to direct, you have to be much more comprehensive. You know, you've got a responsibility for the whole, obviously. So whereas when I'm approaching a part, it's acceptable, and in fact, I think not a bad idea to concentrate almost exclusively on what you have to do. When you're directing, you have to be ready to answer the questions about all the parts. If any of the actors want you to provide an answer, you have to be ready to do so, you know what I mean? You don't want to impose all the answers on the directors, but if any actor says, I have a question about this or I have a question about that, you've got to have the answer. Or you've got to know somebody who does have the answer. What I really hope people take away from it is a view of a kind of compassionate understanding of each other despite our differences. In the particular, the way the play is written, it's about understanding each other across a political divide, from liberal to conservative. But I think what Wendy's saying actually is much broader than that, which is, you know, look at the person and not at the barrier that exists between us. So performances of Third start May 31st. I hope you'll come and see it. And if you do, I hope you enjoy it.